Surely I was intended for far bigger and much better things. Still I wonder when my luck will change. All I request, all I ask, just a little esteem, but alas, such constant disregard. You may well wonder what got you under the weather. And well, what's the use in dwelling on a love we no longer share together? There's only so little a boy can endure, and I can't withstand a second more, 'cause I'm bored. I'm bored. Well, I've been attracting dust, I'm gathering rust, time's a wasting procrastinate, and I'm bored. I'm bored. You may well wonder what got you under the weather. And what's the use in dwelling on a love we no longer share together? You under the weather, and what's the use in dwelling on a love we no longer share together? Ooh. Well, surely I was intended for far bigger and much better things. Still I wonder when my luck will change.
Excellent music there from Anderson, McGinty, Webster, Ward and Fisher. We'll hear from the lads later on as well. More music right here on a brand new show. Welcome to the Atrium. What's it called?
The Atrium.
It's the Atrium. And we'll be here over the next three programmes focusing and highlighting life and what's happening around this beautiful part of the country, Tayside and Fife.
Tonight on the Atrium, we're sending Alan Smith to experience the grunts and groans of professional wrestling in the heart of Perthshire.
Look out for Lycra. Plus, staying with the fitness theme, our personal trainer is Stephen Clarke. He'll be here to show us how to get in shape for spring without breaking the bank.
And Charlie Taylor will be here to show us the latest hair trends this spring.
Plus, journalist and author Lorraine Wilson is our lady with her eye on the arts and culture scene in this area.
But first, there's concern over the high number of deaths in Tayside, which police believe are drug-related. Since January, there's already been 13 deaths due to drug overdoses. The Atrium's AJ Jenkins has been looking into the issue.
Heroin and cocaine, some of the drugs thought to be responsible for 13 suspected drug deaths across Tayside so far this year. Since January, police figures reveal 10 of those are thought to have been caused by Class A drugs, and that's roughly three times the number from the same period last year. In 2011, the figure stood at three, and 12 months before that, cocaine and heroin are thought to have claimed four lives. Police are now expressing concern.
The age range of the victims varies quite considerably, so as far as we could see at the moment, there's no common pattern to these deaths, but obviously quite rightly so, alarming for us that there's been such a number.
And it's not just a problem in Tay territory. Figures published last month in a drug misuse report reveal on average there were nearly 500 drug-related deaths per year in Scotland. But looking at the average number of deaths between 2006 and 2010, Tayside had the second highest number per population. While the report says the number of young people who are taking drugs is falling, it does say that many users have been taking drugs for more than a decade, and it's older users in places like Dundee who are believed to be at greater risk of dying from their addiction.
When people use drugs and don't alter that behaviour, because our intention with treatment is to help people to change what they're doing with drugs, if they don't make those changes, then inevitably using drugs for a long period of time tends to have physical health effects. So there is undoubtedly a move in the statistics over the last 5 years or so where we've seen an older range of people starting to succumb to their drug use.
Those who become ill through drug abuse are advised to seek emergency help as soon as possible, and those dealing the drugs which result in people coming to hospital should be prepared to face the law.
Anyone caught or identified dealing drugs to someone who has unfortunately died as a result of that may face a charge of culpable homicide.
Detectives say it's difficult to tell if the deaths are linked, but they're urging those with an addiction to seek help before it's too late.
And AJ now joins us on the show to talk more about this issue.
Now, this obviously affects friends and families as well, so what can they do to help?
I mean, they have a huge part to play. Statistics say that in the last year, in 60% of overdoses, there was always someone present. So that might have been a friend or family member or another drug user. And they've got a really important part to play because they should be paying attention to the user's breathing. So if their breathing becomes a lot more slow, almost to the point it sounds like they're snoring, that's actually their respiratory system shutting down. So in cases like that, it's vital that they get emergency help as soon as possible.
And what about when it comes to medication? There must be plenty of it readily available in the area, but is it easy or is it difficult to get hold of?
Well, there's been a drug that's been rolled out over the last few years, and it's called naloxone. Basically, drugs like heroin are opiates, and they attack specific receptors in someone's brain. Now, naloxone, it kind of competes with heroin and actually sits and clamps onto these receptors and almost knocks the opiates off. Now, the Scottish Government's been trying to roll this out across the country, and they're hoping that in a few years' time, you know, people who have an issue with drugs could have a ready access to this, basically. And if they have an issue, if they are overdosing, they can get immediate help and take that drug, which will hopefully lessen the damage that can be caused.
And what other help is available for people?
And there's a number of organisations out there across Scotland and Tayside and Fife. In Dundee specifically, just off the top of my head, Ad Action Dundee and Dundee City Alcohol and Drugs Partnership. These are two projects, just two of the many that are out there, that provide help for those with an addiction, but also important services for family members who are dealing with the issue as well, really.
And of course, you can search online as well and look for a nearest drug place in your area.
Plenty online.
Thank you, AJ.
So March is upon us, and we've just seen the likes of New York Fashion Week, London Fashion Week and Paris Fashion Week. And now that it's spring, we're all starting to think about getting a new look. And no one knows about that better than Charlie Taylor. Charlie, you're just back from Prague.
Yes, I am indeed. I'm in a very fortunate position, really, because my job is to look at all the season's looks. So from the fashion weeks that you've just been talking about, and take all these looks and then turn them just as clothes designers do. I then have to turn these looks into commercial hairstyles for the new season. Mm-hmm. So it's literally from catwalk to salon. Right, OK, well, this young lady is a young lady that I work with, and what I would like to do is just kind of create a little bit of magic in front of your very eyes. So what I have done with this hair already is I've prepared the hair and put a curl into the hair. And sometimes what people don't realise is how easy it can be to work with a curl. I think what we tend to do is we see very glamorous hairstyles in magazines or in celebrities, and everybody imagines that it must be really hard to do. But in actual fact, it can be very easy. And what I'm going to do today is just let everyone see how quickly you can get the curl into the hair and then almost make it look picture perfect, like it was an advert for a hair shampoo or a television advert or something like that. So what I've done is I have already prepared the hair. And the other thing people don't realise is that products are your are your biggest help. So if you're using the right products on the hair, it'll make a huge, huge difference. And so what I've done is prepare the hair with a little bit of a styling product, something that helps to hold the curl in and also give volume to the hair.
So this is something that we would put on first?
That's something that we would put on first. And then I've used very simple tongs to put the curl into the hair. OK, and then I'm just going to show you a little trick. Just get rid of this pin, first of all. And get my magic brush, hairdresser's friend. Right. And so what I'm going to do is just use my fingers and I'm going to push into the hair with my fingers. Now, this is very, very easy for people to do themselves. So I'm taking the hair, teasing it, and pushing a curl.
And is that putting a certain amount
hair.
Of volume into it as well when you
Absolutely
do that?
Absolutely it is. Now, at this moment in time, I'm not using a product, but I'm just about to add some product into the hair. OK, so just taking the hair, pushing the curl in, like so. OK, so far I've hardly used my brush. It's all just done with fingers. OK, now if you could just hold that for me, amongst your other things. Now, here's just a little magic trick, and this is how it is literally done for adverts for hair products. When you see on the television and this is a gorgeous girl with all this lovely hair, this is how it's done. So if you just put your head this way, what we do is we just take the hair and wrap it round into a little twist.
And it is as easy as that.
And then push the hair forward. And that's what gives you that very sort of original, I don't know if you remember the days of Jerry Hall when she had the
yes.
most fabulous,
and it sat,
you know,
that, yeah.
just the most beautiful hair. I'm just going to take this product here and then just secure it. And that's what gives that gorgeous sort of wave.
And is this just, what product is this?
Okay, so this is a hairspray. This is my sort of couldn't live without. I do shows all over the world and this definitely has to be with me at all times. So then what we do is we use this as a working spray. It's not a case of just spraying over the top and that's the hair done. You actually then use the spray to style the hair.
Do you think that's a mistake people make, is they just spray it all over rather than working in the hair?
Do you want me to be honest?
Yes.
Sometimes when I'm just, say I was out in a nightclub, which I'm not very often anymore, but just say I was, and I was in a ladies' toilet, and I can see people doing their own hair themselves, what I often see is people just go like that, and all the product's going in one place instead of being distributed through the hair. Or maybe a gel, and the gel just goes like, plump, like that.
So, rather than working in.
Yeah, exactly. So, but I mean, it's all part of the learn, isn't it? So there we go. We're using the spray now to push and re-emphasise the work that we've done with the curl. And there's how you get that most beautiful...
Also, I think sometimes people think, oh, if I put too much product on it, it'll almost look like there's product on it instead
Correct.
Of natural, but that doesn't.
No, it's amazing. And I think that all comes down really to the quality of the product that we're using. So we'll just do this trick again, just on this other side. So just taking control of the hair, giving it a twist through. And this really, truly is just exactly what was happening on the catwalk. And then we're pulling it back. So we've got that absolutely beautiful, healthy, gorgeous hair. And I think probably the colour is worth remarking on as well. I mean, the colour of Kat's hair today is a very, very popular way of colouring at the moment. And it's about grading the colour. So the colour
right.
starts off slightly darker at the roots and then it gets lighter and lighter and lighter as it goes through.
Well, I was going to ask about colour because colour is such a massive thing now as well. And we're seeing a lot of vibrant colours going around just now. Pinks through hair and Katy Perry
Absolutely.
In her blue hair. What sort of colours did you see when you were out?
I mean, being spring, summer, it always brings, it kind of rings the changes, if you like. And when it comes to summer, the blondes are always much fresher. Just like, you know, we've previously coloured Kat's hair just to let you see the sort of freshness of the blondes at the moment. So for spring, summer, that's what happens. The blondes just get a little bit brighter and there's really nice sort of tones of blonde. I saw a lot of evidence of peachy-coloured blondes as well, which is actually very, very pretty. And I know you're talking about the sort of pinks and the Katy Perry blues and this sort of thing. However, there were actually quite a lot of pastel tones around. So pale pinks and pale peaches and
which again matches,
apricots.
Yeah, it matches in with what we see on the fashion because pastels
absolutely
is what's in for the summer as well.
Absolutely. So there was a lot of that. And that's okay if you're blonde, but if you're like me and you're very definitely a brunette, then there were lots of really nice sort of burgundy tones, copper, and anything that promotes that real healthy, shiny hair. That's the one thing that I would bring back this season and say is a must-have. And that is, if your hair's not shining, we've got to be asking the question why. But, you know, I mean, I just did this look because I thought it'd be really nice for people just to see that it isn't that difficult. You know,
no,
I've barely
not.
Used a brush. It's mostly fingers. And there we go.
And
there's
it is just as easy
fabulous.
Rolling it, and you can easily do that at home and when you're away on holiday.
Very easily. It's something that you can actually, if you're doing it yourself, you're doing that way. And it's quite simple to do. So there we go.
Well, we'll all be looking glam this summer.
This season's done.
Yes. Thank you very much, Charlie.
Not at all. It's a pleasure.
Now, the world of wrestling has come a long way since the days of Giant Haystacks and Big Daddy. Do you remember his real name?
Shirley?
He was a big girl, yeah. He was a big chap. He used to watch it every Saturday afternoon, but now it's gone global. It's gone massive. So we had to send our man, our head news honcho, Mr. Alan Smith, to Blairgowrie to find out more. Warning, this piece may contain Lycra.
Ask most people about their views of professional wrestling, it'll most likely conjure up images of sweaty muscleheads in Lycra grappling one another in contests deemed fake. But beyond the stereotyping, it's so much more. Look up Wikipedia. It describes pro wrestling as a spectacle combining athletics and theatrical performance. Long gone are the days of Big Daddy, Giant Haystacks and Mick McManus exciting your granny on a Saturday afternoon. Wrestling these days is big business. Global companies like the WWE and TNA touring the world, with wrestlers becoming idols to generations. Tens of millions of people tuning in weekly to see how certain storylines are progressing. Children buying mountains of merchandise. And with WrestleMania season upon us, interest in the sport is reaching fever pitch. The premier event has brought some larger-than-life figures into the mainstream of pop culture, including the likes of Hulk Hogan, The Ultimate Warrior, Rowdy Roddy Piper, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock.
But all those guys had to start somewhere. That's why I'm here in Blairgowrie tonight, home of Scottish Wrestling Entertainment, the biggest wrestling company in Scotland, based here in Tayside, to find out what it takes to become a professional wrestler.
Professional wrestling isn't just confined to America, with wrestling schools and promotions popping up all over the world. Scottish Wrestling Entertainment was first established in 2004, bringing smaller scale events to cities, towns and communities throughout Tayside. It was started by promoter David Lowe, more commonly known to local wrestling fans as Braveheart.
We used to train one day a week, which was a Saturday, for 2 hours, 6 till 8. And then more people came along and went up it to 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. And by 2000, we had our own training centre in the Vega in Emma Street. And it was so popular that we were training for a whole weekend, all day Saturday, all day Sunday. The ring would go up early in the Saturday morning, we would train right through to the Sunday night, and everyone would go back home to wherever they came from. And at that time, there was only a couple of wrestling schools in Scotland, but the SWE was really making a name for itself.
With time, the SWE has grown to become the largest wrestling promotion in Scotland, putting on the biggest such events every year. Hell for Lycra, which has been staged in the Bonner Hall in Dundee over the last 2 years, has seen some of the sport's biggest names come to Tayside. This year again is promising to be no different.
Hell for Lycra 6, we took a little gamble and we did it in Perth Concert Hall and we sold it out. We brought over the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase and Rory McAllister. And because of the success of the event and the way that the SWE treated the million-dollar man, he came back the following year for Hell for Lycra 7. And then last year, Ted, he actually bought the SWE He bought the SWE and he came back to Helford Lycra 8 along with Virgil and Tatanka, the Native American Tatanka. And this year, Helford Lycra 9, we have the million-dollar man coming back here, which says a lot for a wrestling promotion. No other wrestling promotion in Scotland has had this kind of tie-in with WWE Hall of Famers or legends, that they can bring them back, get them involved in storylines, get them buying their promotion.
And for anyone thinking about getting started in the wild world of wrestling, there are some key attributes you'll need if you want to lace up them boots.
To be a trainee here at Heartland, you really need to have integrity. It's one of the things that I really look for. I think everyone should have integrity to be involved in the SWE first and foremost. And anybody that we work alongside, they must have integrity. They must have a willingness to learn and, you know, to be a team player. When they come in, they want to give 110%.
So I've heard everything I needed to hear from Dave here, and I've seen the Heartland trainees do what they want to do, so I think I'm ready to try my hand at becoming a professional wrestler. So what do I need to get involved?
I think first of all you need to get changed. You can't wrestle in this. So go put that on and we'll see what you look like.
Just this. I can't have shorts or
no,
just a t-shirt, no?
No, just that. On you go. And it'll be fear.
Okay, I'm about to go and try and squeeze into this. So join me in 5 minutes and let's see if I can become a professional wrestler. I've managed to squeeze into this, what do you call it, a leotard?
It's a singlet.
A singlet. I've managed to squeeze into a singlet. I must admit, I'm feeling rather exposed. So am I good to go? Am I ready to go?
I feel a little bit exposed.
Yeah.
Well, you have a perfect face for radio, so this should cover up the exposure. Here you are.
Like I've heard that before. Eh? So I've got the gear, and including the mask, which fortunately enough fits. So it's time to go inside the ring and... let's kick Braveheart's backside. If you still think that you want to become a professional wrestler, David here's got all the information on how you can do it. Where should they go to get the information? Quickly!
You can log on to swonline.co.uk or the training page. All the information's there. You can email one of the coaches and they'll get straight back to you. Or you can call 0773-144-0929. Do you have what it takes to be a pro wrestler?
Do you have what it takes? I'm tapping out. I'm done.
Alan Smith reporting, and sweating and grunting and probably chafing as well. Now, staying with the fitness theme, over the next three programmes, we'll be joined by our very own Atrium personal trainer, Mr. Stephen Clarke, the man with a boy band hairdo and the abs like a George Foreman grill. Definitely puts me to shame. Stephen's going to talk us through a few moves to keep us in shape for the spring, and it won't break the bank either. He's with me now with a lady in a dubious position. Stephen, what's happening here?
OK, before we do any sort of exercise, I'm just getting Gunnell to do some mobility exercises, OK? So swap legs here, Gunnell. So all we're doing is staying on knees position, bringing one leg forward, and just trying to get a little bit more range of movement through the hips. So as you're doing, it's just a kind of gradual movement, nice and smooth, not trying to injure yourself at all.
Always important to warm up then.
It is. OK, do that one more time. And just stretch into it. Good. OK, so the kind of first thing we need to start thinking about is a warm-up. We don't want to injure ourselves. We don't want to pull any muscles. So that's what I've been doing with Gunnell there. OK, I want to stand up there, Gunnell. Like you said, we don't want to kind of break the bank. Being fit and healthy isn't expensive. You can do it in your own home. You can do it in your own time. You don't have to find time. You can make time.
It's just a case of fitting it into our busy daily schedules.
Exactly.
And working out and getting into the routine of doing it as well.
Yeah, and if you know a few basic exercises to do, then there's no reason why you can't put the dinner on, do some exercises for 5 minutes, and then take the dinner out of the oven.
Do exercises while you're cooking the dinner, maybe squatting and frying at the same time.
Exactly. And I can actually show you a squat right now. Now, most people have heard of a squat. You are just bending your legs, squatting down. What I'm going to show you with help of Gunnell is a wide leg squat. Now, the reason we do this, a wide leg squat actually works the inside of your legs and your glutes a little bit more. Okay, the problem areas for a lot of females. What I want to do is, if you go a little bit wider with your legs there, Gunnell, okay, so what we're looking at is slightly wider than your shoulders with your feet, toes pointing roughly at a 45-degree angle. Okay, now if you bring your arms out in front of you, now as Gunnell kind of sinks into it, she's going to stick her bum out slightly behind her. Now you see her knees are going out to the side here. Now as you come back up again, you're trying to squeeze the muscles in the inside of the leg and the glutes to kind of lift your body up. Okay, and do that again for me.
Looks quite difficult.
Down.
For me,
it's
anyway.
It's very, very easy. Now our feet are perfectly flat on the floor and then slowly come back up again. Like I said, this is an easy exercise, and I'm sure you could do it as well, sure.
Okay, let's give
can
it a
give
shot.
Can you give us a try?
Yeah, let's give it
can
a shot.
Give it a try, okay.
Now, but while I'm squatting, Stephen, you have to tell me, how important is it to maintain a healthy diet and a balance between the two and exercise?
You know, exercise is very important, but it's only a small part of it. Having adequate nutrition to go along with it. Now, if you bring your arms up...
Oh, yeah, like this.
Okay,
right.
Now, if you just stick your bum out slightly behind you as you go down, keep the head up. That's it, and then come back up there.
Oh, yeah, yeah, now, I can feel that.
Back position is the most important thing. You had a perfectly straight back there, paramount to any good squat. OK, let's do that again.
It's the kind of thing you can do when you're in the shower as well.
To make this a little bit harder, what I want you to do is, before you come back up again, pop down and hold. Hold that position now. I want you to start thinking about the muscles on the inside of your leg and your glutes. Now, squeeze those muscles to lift back up.
Oh, yeah.
OK, you start to feel those muscles?
The slower, the better.
Exactly. And if you can really squeeze hard, you start to work the muscles a little bit more. Now, if you can do 15 to 20 of those, have a short rest after 20, maybe do that 3 times, you start to work the muscles quite well, and you have very toned legs. But more importantly, you start to get your heart and lungs working, which is really what we're looking for here for health reasons.
There must be a number of other exercises because that's mainly good for the legs and your back and your posture
it
and so
is,
on.
It is.
What other? So, what else can we do in the home?
Well, if we want to start working upper body, we could. Can we get a chair in here? If we can get a chair to do some tricep dips, then we can start to work the back of the arms as well as the shoulders. And again, for a lot of people, having this kind of posture, having a kind of nice toned arms, everyone wants that, especially coming up to the summertime. No, you want the toned arms.
Yeah,
we've got a chair.
Yeah, let's nick an audience member's seat.
Excellent.
They can stand for a while.
Okay, Gunnell, if I can ask you to have a seat. Now, for a tricep dip, what we're looking at is a bend from the arms, okay? So if you can bring your legs a little bit closer in. Now, just to make it easier, we keep the legs close into the chair. Okay, now from that position, Gunnell's going to bend her arms gently down. Now, what we're looking for is this to be level with the floor and come back up slowly. And as you come up, we're working the muscles at the back here, okay? Nice triceps. Okay, do that again. Good. And then slowly back up. Again, we're working the front of the shoulders and the back of the arms. So it's good for when you're wearing maybe strappy tops, for guys who are wearing tight T-shirts. Okay, have a seat there and have a little rest.
Not all of us can pull off a tight T-shirt, Stephen. but, I mean, is it a good idea to keep doing these until you feel your muscles getting burned or...
You should always have some sort of...
set number.
Have some sort of structure to it. Yeah. So to begin with, maybe do 15 repetitions. See how your arms feel, see how you're feeling, but it's all about challenging yourself. So up to 15 would be a good challenge, and if you want to make it harder, then there's ways around it, either do more, or if you go back into that position, Gunnell, just by moving your legs slightly further away from the chair, you actually make it harder. And if you do that again for me, excellent, and slowly back up again. Do that again. Now, just because the feet are slightly further away, it puts a lot more pressure on the arms. Again, okay, rest. If you aim for, again, 15 repetitions, you're going to start to feel the arms working, the front of the shoulders. And again, having a short rest and doing maybe three sets of 15 will start to kind of feel those muscles working.
Very important not to overdo it when you're first starting.
It is. Again, a lot of people will try to do too much, trying to get fit and healthy. But the most important thing about exercise is the recovery afterwards. We train to create a stimulus in the body so that your body can recover afterwards. And a lot of people forget that. A lot of people don't know that. But the recovery is the most important thing. And you mentioned before about, you know, keeping a healthy diet, nutrition. Again, it's paramount to your training. There's no point in pushing your body to its limit to then not eat the right foods.
Splurge out on a Saturday night pizza.
Exactly. You need good quality lean protein, simple carbohydrates that are going to be slow release. And again, fat is important in your diet. A lot of people forget that also. You need healthy fats in your diet. So it's staying away from the cookies and the crisps, all the bad fats. But nuts and seeds, eggs, oily fish, very, very good. And believe it or not, the more healthy fats you have in your diet, the more likely your body is to burn the bad ones. So healthy combination of proteins, carbohydrates and fats are definitely important.
And talking to Gunnell as well, your model, before we came on, she's a busy mum of four and she manages to fit fitness into her schedule as well.
She certainly is.
Anyone can do it, really.
Gunnell looks after four kids. If you can do it with four kids and a busy lifestyle, then anybody can do it. And that's the whole point of these exercises. You can do it any time.
It's about remembering and getting it into a routine.
Exactly.
Stephen Clarke from Stephen Clarke Fitness is our personal trainer here at the Atrium, and he'll be with us for the next 2 weeks. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Gunnell.
On the Atrium, we're not only going to bring you a wide variety of topics of interest to Tayside and Fife, but we're also going to be looking at recommendations of what you can get up to throughout this vibrant area. And here to tell us more is Lorraine Wilson.
Hello. Hello there. Well, there's lots to do. Get out from your living rooms, watch the Atrium, and then get out and see some great live music and theatre and arts and comedy. It's all happening. And music's particularly interesting over the next couple of weeks, because if you see lots of old punks hobbling about with bondage trousers on and walking stick, it's because it's a deluge of punk in Dundee over the next couple of weeks. We've got Spear of Destiny, Stiff Little Fingers, GBH, Vic Goddard. I mean, it's incredible. All at Fat Sam's and the Beat Generator. So just right round the corner as well, if your walking isn't too great anymore.
Does that mean Mohicans are back as well?
I certainly hope so. Next time?
Yes.
Next get Charlie,
Charlie
back to
Taylor,
do that?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We'll get it to do it.
So into Angus at the Pitlochry Festival Theatre. Great things out of season there. Alvin Stardust, The Man in Black.
Stuart's favourite.
Well, you
say
that.
You like
Tom? We're back to dodgy hairdos again. I had a hairdo like Alvin Stardust in the 80s.
I just pay tribute with the big jewellery, and that'll do me absolutely fine.
When is he performing then?
He's performing on Saturday, March the 18th, so get that in your diary.
It's quite a big name.
Yeah,
there's always
actually
a lot of big names that come to Tayside and Fife, and I believe there's a big comedian coming here soon as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. I mean, a lot of people probably see this guy on all the panel shows, QI and all these kind of things. He's a really kind of crabby old American guy, but very funny, very dry, and his name's Rich Hall.
He is very
And he's
funny.
Coming to the Adam Smith Theatre on the Friday, March the 16th.
It's like an American Jack D, or is he Canadian? But he never smiles, so watch out for him smiling if you go and see Rich Hall.
Exactly. He'll be smiling if you turn up, I think. That'll be very nice at the moment. But if we get into theatre, this is one for you guys. Dancing Queen, A Night of ABBA. What do you think about that?
Yeah, well, she's got the sparkly outfit.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. She knows the dance moves.
Very different from Mamma Mia. No story here, just big productions, song and dance of all the favourites. You can imagine the girls will be there with their pink Stetsons and, you know, bottles of Lambrusco in the handbag and having a good dance in the aisles. It'll be fantastic. And straight after that, very different, Reasons to be Cheerful, the Ian Dury and the Blockheads musical.
Yeah, punk again.
It looks
absolutely
really good.
Yeah. I mean, it's going to be a part gig, part musical, but it's all about these three guys who are desperate to get into a sold-out show of Ian Dury and the Blockheads in 1979. So really good fun, nice and up. Obviously, all the great hits, Hit Me With Your Rhythm Stick, Reasons to be Cheerful, all the stuff that people love.
It's had some amazing reviews from newspapers across the UK as well.
Yeah.
Looks like a decent show.
Yeah. At the Gardyne Theatre, local interest, the Mother of All Peoples, the Mary Slessor story, the fantastic missionary who was actually Aberdeen-born but a real Dundee daughter. And that's going to be here at the Gardyne Theatre from the 22nd to the 24th of March. Great production, great, kind of lots of humour in it, as well as a really kind of serious subject. So that's well worth seeing.
And there's also a serious... Is it a theatre show with a man talking about his experiences of being kidnapped in India?
It's actually a photography exhibition. It's some charming snakes. A young photographer called Ross Fraser-McLean, who has actually taken some fantastic photographs of the Anders and McGinty guys as well. Ross is a real kind of adventurer, a proper traveller, and he went through India last summer. And instead of kind of going and taking the Taj Mahal and all the usual things, he was actually held against his will for 3 weeks in a mountain village from this caste who used to be snake charmers. And now it's outlawed by the Indian government, so they're kind of living on the fringes of society. And for those 3 weeks, Ross documented everything that happened there, and now it's an absolutely fascinating exhibition, and that's at the Hannah McClure Centre and Aberdeen University.
And that happened as recent as last summer?
Last summer, yeah. Fantastic story.
Yeah.
I mean, he's an incredible guy. He travels everywhere and takes fantastic, fantastic stories. But
So what you're saying, Lorraine, is there's loads always going on around Tayside and Fife. You just either
incredible.
Have to watch the atrium to find out where
absolutely.
It's all happening.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out online as well. Thank you, Lorraine. Well
Thanks, said. Guys.
And that's it for the first ever Atrium. Thank you for watching. Next time on this brand new show,
AG Jenkins will be back to talk about another issue affecting Tayside and Fife.
We send Alan Smith out to do more grunting. This time he's looking at the area of American football in this area.
Oh dear. Also, we'll be back.
Oh, well, we hope.
We hope.
We'll see, and we'll have live music as well next time on the Atrium from Savannah Swing. But now, to play us out, and you have to stick around for this, these guys are amazing and they're going to get bigger and bigger. Please give it up for Anderson, McGinty, Webster, Ward and Fisher.
That's all right. Forgetting to remember that you're lonely is everything you need to know tonight. If every minute and every hour of tomorrow you taste the lingerings of yesterday, we're no recreation, it ain't no substitutions. You say I'm down, but I'm only down today. Cause then I don't know why. My heavy mama was full of intentions, but now I'm nothing to lose. Oh, Dana, well, I'm not asking you to leave him. If you belong where you come from, fine. But Dana, will you comfort me tonight? Well, now I think I remember that I heard you say hanging with the loonies has made you feel sane. So hanging on to sanity, it ain't their kind of game. Girl, get out of my way. Take a trip if you desire. Just don't be around when the spark turns to fire and the haunts. now I've nothing to lose. Oh, Dana, well, I'm not asking you to leave him. If you know where you come from, fine. Dana, will you comfort me tonight? Petrolheads keep the carriageways from slumber, and he's a lion sleeping soundly by your side. When midnight's just another lonely number, you can tell off your excuses, oh girl, when you're right. Dana, I don't know why I had you over. Is it just to know that I could? My heavy mama was full of intentions, but now nothing's a loser. Oh, Dana, well, I'm not asking you to leave him. If you belong where you come from, fine. Dana, will you comfort me tonight? Dana, will you comfort me tonight? When feeding the mouth that bites you makes you hungry for someone else's arms, that's all right.